Wizards of the Coast drops a stealth D&D release, plus the MCDM RPG approaches.
It's finally happening!
Welcome to Tabletop Newsday, our occasional midweek look at all the fantasy and tabletop news that we haven't previously talked about in a video. Today, we're talking about a surprise new Wizards of the Coast D&D drop, the long-awaited MCDM RPG, and a chance to check out one of Dimension 20's most popular seasons for free. Now, as a reminder, if you like these kinds of well-produced and timely news videos, be sure to leave us a like and subscribe so we can keep making them more than once a week. Now, on to the news!
News team, assemble!
Wizards of the Coast has stealth dropped a 286-page D&D rulebook that's only available on the DM's Guild and is written by the designer of the original Baldur's Gate video games. Chains of Asmodeus is a new Nine Hells-themed sourcebook that includes a high-level adventure for level 11 to 20 characters, stat blocks for Asmodeus and all the other major archdevils, campaign setting details on the Nine Hells, and a new item corruption mechanic. The sourcebook was written by James Olin and Adrian Tchaikovsky, the former of which is best known for being the designer of Baldur's Gate 1 and 2 and Knights of the Old Republic. Now, the reason for the DM's Guild release is because Olin is actually a Wizards of the Coast employee, working with a new AAA game studio. Olin had launched Arcanum World as a publishing company after leaving BioWare, and has continued to publish periodic D&D material even after getting hired by Wizards of the Coast. Notably, all the proceeds for Chains of Asmodeus goes to Extra Life, a charity that benefits children hospitals. Now, this is a $29.99 supplement, but Olin's previous D&D work has been generally well received, and the proceeds go to charity. So this is probably one Wizards of the Coast release that you should probably check out.
Probably.
The MCDM RPG is coming. MCDM Productions has announced that they will launch the Kickstarter for their unnamed RPG in December. You may remember that MCDM started to design this RPG earlier in the year in the aftermath of the OGL debacle. While the OGL wasn't the catalyst for MCDM focusing on their own project, it certainly did increase interest in the new game. We reached out to lead designer James Introcaso, who said, "I can say it'll be a heroic, cinematic, tactical fantasy RPG, and that we're hard at work on the core of the game now. We've been doing tons of testing, I'm currently working on version 23 of the rules, and we plan to dial it in so that we can hit all of those goals. We're also blogging about the development on our Patreon, and I talk about the design of the game every Wednesday on Twitch." Now, this and Daggerheart will be two of the biggest RPGs in 2024, along with the Stormlight RPG, so we're excited to hear more about this project soon.
I gotta have more! I gotta have more!
Games Workshop has released the first set of rules for Warhammer The Old World, its upcoming quasi-relaunch of the classic Warhammer Fantasy line. The game, while drawing inspiration from past Warhammer Fantasy games, is specifically called out as a new game and will feature four phases: the strategy phase, movement phase, shooting phase, and combat phase. Now, Games Workshop revealed a little bit more details about the strategy phase in a recent article, and it mentioned that the strategy phase is basically when special actions and rules go into effect for most units. Games Workshop also mentioned that the game will also feature things like morale and psychology, rules that really aren't a part of other Warhammer games. Now, Warhammer The Old World will be released sometime in early 2024, and we can't wait.
Can't wait!
Want to get caught up on Fantasy High ahead of the highly anticipated third season next year? Well, Dropout has just dropped all of Fantasy High sophomore year on YouTube this week. All of Fantasy High freshman year was previously dropped on YouTube, so now you can watch every episode of the extremely popular Dimension 20 storyline for free whenever you want. Fantasy High is one of the best actual play seasons that we've ever watched, and the sophomore year is, some say is even better, so be sure to give it a watch today.
Check this out!
And finally, the Crooked Moon crossed the $3 million mark with just over 2 days remaining from the end of its Kickstarter campaign. Now, this is a folk horror 5e supplement written by the Legends of Avantress team, and in general, pretty impressive. So congrats to the whole Legends of Evantress team, and if you're watching this video early enough, be sure to check out that Kickstarter before it ends.
To me, that's beautiful.
So, what was your favorite news story of the week? Let us know and be sure to hit those like and subscribe buttons.